Hello everybody, thanks for watching this video. If you're a subscriber, sure do appreciate it. If not, consider doing so. And don't forget to give the video a thumbs up. Hey everybody, it's John W5CYF and welcome to the Ham Shack Project Base today. Going to be building a very small but works very well QRP dummy load. Now this dummy load, I'll show you how you can make it in two different ways. It's extremely easy to make, doesn't take long to make, doesn't take hardly any skill at all to make. The circuit is extremely simple. I'll show you how to do that in just a moment. But what this is a QRP dummy load, and I've made this one to attach directly to the back of whatever I'm testing. Every once in a while with a little QRP transmitter that I've built, sometimes I have to go back and do some troubleshooting. Well, instead of having a bunch of adapters or coax, I can just put it all together on this one little QRP dummy load. Now, a couple of caveats. This is a very low power, would not put much more than about 5 watts in it. All of my QRP stuff is done between 3 and 4 watts, so this is perfectly acceptable to do that. And again, you can make it with or without the coax. I'll show you a couple of options. It takes, if you take your time, it'll probably take you 45 minutes to build it. Once you build one, you can build another one in about 20 minutes. The parts, again, extremely easy to find and a very easy circuit. Let's go to the workbench and get started on the QRP dummy load. So let's go ahead and get to building here. What you're going to need are some double-sided PCB. And what I use are pieces that are about 2 inches by 1/2 inch. And the reason you'll see in a moment that it doesn't need to be over 1/2 inch wide. When you get your piece, PC board double-sided, you're going to make 3 pads on each side. And make sure that you check with your ohmmeter and make sure that you really are separated between those sides. And you'll do that on both sides of the printed circuit board. You'll have actually 6 pads, 3 per side. The way that I cut the grooves in the PC board, I've had this little miter box and saw, X-Acto saw, for quite a few years. You'll have your own favorite way. But I just do that, and that's the way I cut those grooves in there. And if you've cut PC board before, sometimes it can be a little tough, and you want to make sure, as I said, to make sure that you're always making sure that you've got separation between those pads. Otherwise, your dummy load is not going to work. So you're going to need that little piece of PCB board. You're going to need 8 100-watt resistors. 100 ohm resistors, and I buy these packages at a time off eBay for little or nothing out of China. You're going to need this BNC connector, and this one is the one that I use because I attach it right to the back of the radio, and I'm not attaching it into another piece of coax. If you're going to attach it to another piece of coax, there's other ways that you can make this. I'll show you another way that you can do it. You're also going to need a little piece of RG174. That's what I use. This is about 6 inches long, just whatever you think is handy. You'll need a little piece of wire to connect it to ground everything out okay. You'll also need two caps, and for some reason the other cap rolled away, but you'll need two half-inch copper caps and a little piece of half-inch copper tubing. And that's why this part right here needs to be less than 1/2 inch, because that's going to stick up in there and keep everything in tight. In addition to that, you're going to need about 2 feet of Teflon tape. So that's the material list that you'll need. Let's go ahead and I'll show you how to get this started and how it's designed and how it looks. Now, this design is a very common one. It comes off the internet. And here's the way it is. This is the PCB board right here, and it's broken into 3 different sections. Section 1 right here, section 2 in the middle, and then section 3 right there. Now, the resistors, there's 4 per side, and this is how you get your 100 ohm load. You'll need 8 of those, 4 per side. And you'll see how they soldered up here in just a minute, but they leap over where that section break is. So you've got your load coming in here, it jumps over, it ties into the second resistor and jumps over to where it goes into the BNC connector. And then the other side also has four. I'm only showing two per side here, but as I said before, there's actually 800 ohm resistors, four per side, to give you a 50 ohm load. You'll also need to tie that together. I just use a little jumper to come across both sides of the board. And this end right here goes to the BNC center, whatever part you're going to be using, but it's going to go right to the center part. And then the board is going to come down and go to the BNC ground. Very, very simple circuit. Again, it's found all over the internet. You can look for just a QRP dummy load, and you'll be able to find this circuit. So let's go ahead and I'll get started building. And the first thing to do is just go ahead, and I'm not going to take the time to do this, but you'll just need to go ahead and bend over your resistors to where they're going to be laying like that. And I'll just go ahead and solder those. I'm not going to take you through all the soldering process, but again, there's going to be four per side, and that's the way I start them out. I just solder one, two, and just loop them across. Neatness does count, but it's all going to be covered up anyway. The main thing is you just want to get them stuck. I'll be back after everything gets soldered. One thing that I do when I lay those resistors down, or to get ready to lay them on that pad, I bend them, and I'll try to draw this from the end view, but looking at the end of the resistor, I have bent that down like that the first time, and that's my 90 degree bend. And then I just take a pair of pliers, and then I come in and kind of put a little leg out to the side on it. And by doing that, yeah, you probably can't see it in there, but it comes down straight and then off at a little 90 degree angle. And what that does, that makes it sit just a little bit better, because you're going to be soldering eight of these or four of these to the side, and that makes them sit in there just a little bit better, and it makes them look a little bit better, even though we're going to cover it totally with Teflon tape.